Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Tonight we're making hamburgers, and they're a little bit unusual because they're going to be square hamburgers. And they're square because we're making them on slices of bread instead of a hamburger bun. So let's begin our procedure. We pick our bread, and for this I chose something called hearty white bread. You might want to use whole wheat. I normally use whole wheat bread just because I think it's healthier. But I thought this might come out better in the demonstration if I use just two slices for one hamburger of hearty sliced bread. Now I've already worked on these a bit, so here are two slices that I have spread butter on the side that's up here, and then I used a skillet like the one sitting over there and toasted those two sides. So I'm going to be building my hamburger there. So we have done a little of the work ahead of time, and I can put this bread back in here. We'll make the rest of the hamburgers later. I'm just doing one at the demonstration. Now I'm mixing up enough to do six, but actually I think I'm going to make these kind of oversized, so it probably won't do that many for me. It just depends on how you want to make them. So we start out with a pound of lean ground beef. Now, this is not as lean as I usually get. This is 8% fat instead of the 4% that I usually use. When you fry hamburgers, and I'm going to fry this in a skillet, it really needs a little grease to get going. And if you just don't have any fat in your ground beef, it won't work very well. So we have 1 pound, and I have one egg that's beaten. So I'm going to put this pound of ground beef in that bowl. I think there's a little paper on the bottom here. And then I'm going to add some seasonings. What I have here is 1 teaspoon of salt. It's always my rule for hamburger or ground beef. For 1 pound of ground beef, you need 1 teaspoon of salt. Now, to make this a little spicier, we're going to put some garlic powder in, 1/4 teaspoon for this amount of ground beef. And then we need some black pepper, and we'll just kind of shake in enough that would be to taste. So I'm not giving a specific measurement. Do as much as you like of that. Now, I'm going to do something that's a little unusual for hamburgers. Instead of just going with my hands like this and forming it, which I will form it with my hands later on, I'm going to use my mixer and beat this. I always do that with meatloaf, and it makes it so much better. It's just smoother, and I'm going to do that with this hamburger. So this is going to make some noise. Let me go away, get this beat up, and we'll come right back. What I've done is divide my mixture of ground beef with spices into 3 equal balls, and that would be 1/3 of a pound each. And this one I have flattened into sort of a rectangular shape. I'm looking at the shape of my bread, and I want it to fit that pretty well. It will shrink down some, so this is going to a hot skillet. Actually, I haven't heated my skillet yet, but I'm going to put this in a hot skillet. I'm going to brown it up on both sides, and I'm going to have it cooked all the way through. I like mine well done, and so we're cooking it all the way through, and then I'll come back and build the hamburger for you. This is the fried hamburger after it has come out of the skillet, and I'm going to pat a little bit of the grease off of it. And actually, if you want it browned up like this on the outside, it's a good idea to put a little olive oil in. And I did that just to make sure that we would have a nice brown outside. I want to make sure that it got done all the way through, so I'm going to just make a little slice here. We'll take a look. Yes, I think that is done all the way through. So here's our assembly. We take our 2 pieces of bread, and each one of them gets the same treatment. I have some mayonnaise out here. This is mayo free, so it has no fat. And I'm just going to use what I have out here. Didn't want to dip back into that container and contaminate it. So I'm just going to dip from this little measuring cup, but it's no specific measure. Just put your mayonnaise on the toasted part of the bread. The underside has not been toasted. And that will get you started in making your hamburger. Actually, this is going to be a cheeseburger because the next step is to put a slice of cheese on each side. And you can see this is what I use, deluxe American. You can use cheddar cheese, Swiss cheese, any kind of cheese that you particularly like on your hamburger. And then the next step is to saute some onion. I have sauteed half of an onion this size, and that would be for the whole recipe, but we're making just 1/3 of it. So I'm going to give this side a little bit, sauteed onions, and just bring it down to the end too. It's not just the cheese part that gets it, and give this side a little bit of sauteed onions. Those will taste really good when you bite into it. Don't overdo it with the onions because that could be a little too oniony for you. Then you're going to put your hamburger at this point, and then we will close it up, and it needs to match, so it goes like that. And we're going to take it back to the stove and grill this outer part. The top and the bottom have not been grilled, so let me just bring my skillet over here. Get this over a bit, and then I'm going to take some softened butter and just spread the top. And the reason I do this is that I don't like to melt butter and then grill something in it standing in butter, because it just absorbs too much fat. This way you get that nice buttery crispy flavor, but you don't have any more butter than what you put on there and spread. So this goes upside down, and that exposes the other side that you're going to butter. So try to get to all corners of it. And then this goes back on the stove. We'll grill it until we look underneath and see that that bottom side is brown. And then we'll turn it over and we'll get the top side brown. And I'll see you back when it's done.
When your square hamburger is done on both sides, browned up like this, then you need to remove it from the skillet and put it on a plate. I'm going to cut this straight down the middle. I think this is really a masculine looking burger, and so I'm not trying to introduce any delicacies into it. This is the complete dinner that my husband and I have been working on. We have our herb seasoned oven baked fries, which are going to be nice and healthy. There are plenty more of those, but we'll just split them however we want to. We decided to split the one hamburger because it is so thick and rich. And then we have two dill spears, and we have some ketchup for our fries, and a nice cold Coke.